Let's start with a headline from our sports medicine team. According to their new study, high school athletes aren't sitting on the sidelines long enough after a concussion. Recently published research by Henry Ford suggests that on average, young athletes should wait 30 days before getting back in the game after their first concussion. Right now, Michigan High School Athletic Association rules say players showing signs of a concussion are benched for just 24 hours. Players on teams staffed by a Henry Ford athletic trainer are out for at least 5 days.
We're gonna slowly bring you back, and I explain why we're gonna slowly bring you back. We don't want to just throw you out there where you're gonna get hit again, and then we're dealing with second impact syndrome.
The new research isn't likely to change rules right away, but study co-author Dr. Bill Matsuris says the hope is it will start to change minds.
When you recognize that it can be up to 30 days to get a young student athlete back, you're going to change your mindset on how you advance them, in terms of how you push them, in terms of how you test them.
The study examined the records of 357 high school athletes treated for concussions at Henry Ford from 2013 to 2016. The findings also suggest female athletes, players with prior concussions, and those with delayed diagnosis may take more than 30 days to recover. Matsuris says research also revealed that student athletes' brains don't heal as quickly as experts previously thought.
We thought that concussion issues would be very short-lived, that they wouldn't have as many attention issues, that they'd be able to recover to their sport much quicker, and we found the opposite.
Before the study, it was believed that a brain injury was like most others. The younger the athlete, the shorter the recovery time.
So we need more studies on the younger athlete. Many of us have children. We're all worried about them. We all wanted them to be safe. So we need to recognize that this is a problem for the youth athlete.
While research finds that concussions are still most likely in football, hockey, and soccer, that doesn't mean they aren't a concern across the board. In fact, our trainer tells us that every year for 4 years, she treated at least one swimmer with a concussion.